Okay, good morning students. Here we start with the gross anatomy lecture of the portal vein. So therefore, the gross anatomy lecture of portal vein, very often it is asked as a short note. We start with the definition of the portal vein and various points which we will define. Then the formation of portal vein, and then the course of portal vein and relations. Along with the course we have the relations, and then applied anatomy. So applied anatomy will be in the end. Definition, see the various points. The portal vein will carry the blood from the abdominal part of alimentary tract. So it will carry blood from abdominal part of alimentary tract. It will carry the blood from abdominal part of alimentary tract across various abdominal organs also, except lower part of rectum and anal canal. So except lower part of rectum and anal canal, the blood is drained via capillary plexus. And through these capillary plexus, they are carried through various capillaries, and these capillaries will then form the portal vein. Now this blood which is collected will relay in. Where will it relay? It is carried through the alimentary tract, but this blood will be carried through the portal vein into the hepatic sinusoids of the liver. So it will be relayed into the hepatic sinusoids of the liver. This is the definition of portal vein. Now in the definition of portal vein, one more sentence is added. This portal vein will start, it will begin as capillary plexus in the formation of a vein. Typical vein, but when it ends, it will end as arterial type in such a way that it will end in hepatic sinusoids. So it will end as artery like, but it will begin as vein like. Now in the same definition we will include one more point, and that point will be the portal vein is devoid of valves. Please note down, portal vein and its tributaries, they are devoid of valves. This is very important. Many times this is asked in one mark question answer. So the entire portal vein and its tributaries, they don't have any valves. And the last question which was asked in MCQ, this last point is, there are two streams of blood in portal vein, right and left streams of blood. Right stream of blood in the portal vein is conveyed by superior mesenteric vein, and it will pass through right branch of portal vein. It will always be passing through right branch of portal vein. So this is one point. Splenic vein, the splenic vein will carry blood from the left part of the portal vein and will relay through the left branch of portal vein. So it will relay through the left branch of portal vein. So in this way, this was also asked in MCQ, there are two streams of blood through the portal vein. Sorry. On the right stream is formed by, the right stream of the blood is formed by the superior mesenteric vein, which will relay into the right branch of portal vein, and the left stream of blood in the portal vein is formed by splenic vein, which will carry the blood to the left branch of portal vein. So here we finish all these points of the definition. Now formation. The formation of portal vein, it is formed by combination of or joining of superior mesenteric vein and splenic vein. So superior mesenteric vein plus splenic vein. This is the formation. And this formation will take place exactly at vertebral level number L2. Please note down. This is asked in MCQ. At what vertebral level, various options will be there. This is the vertebral level where the formation of the portal vein takes place, at vertebral level L2 and behind the neck of pancreas. This is where the formation of portal vein will take place, where the superior mesenteric vein will join with the splenic vein at the level of L2 behind the neck of the pancreas to form portal vein. Course. We are going to draw the diagram. I'll explain it to you. Now course. The entire course is divided into two different halves. First half, when you start from below, is extrahepatic. So this is extrahepatic course. Second part above, intrahepatic course. So our course of portal vein is divided into two segments, extrahepatic and intrahepatic. Based upon these two courses, extrahepatic course and intrahepatic course, we will discuss the relations. And mainly the relations of portal vein will be discussed only with respect to extrahepatic course. So with the respect to extrahepatic course, the relations are divided into, now see how interesting it is, the relations are divided into three segments, three categories. And how, what structure divides these relations of extrahepatic course? First part of duodenum. So first part of duodenum will divide the extrahepatic course into three segments, very simple, and those three segments are infraduodenal, retroduodenal, supraduodenal. Very simple. So therefore here I will mention infraduodenal part of the course, which lies below the first part of the duodenum, retroduodenal part, retroduodenal, that means that will lie behind the first part of duodenum, and supraduodenal, which will lie above the first part of duodenum. In this way we discuss the course and relations of extrahepatic part of portal vein. So the relations of extrahepatic part of portal vein will be infraduodenal, retroduodenal and supraduodenal. And then in the last we will discuss the tributaries. And in the last we will discuss the applied anatomy. So therefore, when we, I'll just take here, please come on this side, we'll just draw a simple line diagram, enlarged view, in which, I will draw here. Let me draw here. Now, this is the duodenum, which I am drawing. So here, I will draw the duodenum. So this entire duodenum, first part, second part, third part. Now we know that here I will draw the pancreas. So therefore, pancreas I will draw with, I will use violet color. So therefore, if I draw the pancreas here, this is how I will show the pancreas. And this is how I will show uncinate process, the head, the neck. Now, this is the uncinate process of the pancreas. Now I will show the neck portion. So this much region will serve as the neck of the pancreas. Uncinate process, head, neck and body, and then the tail of pancreas. Now, what will show is the formation of portal vein. Remember, it is just behind the neck of the pancreas, behind the neck of the pancreas at the level of L2. So this level here, I will mention this level as L2. So therefore, this is the level of L2. Now here, the portal vein, I will use blue color, it is formed by joining of superior mesenteric vein. So superior mesenteric vein will be coming from here. This is how the superior mesenteric vein is crossing. And I will draw here, put some color inside, and I will show this is the superior mesenteric vein. And then this superior mesenteric vein will travel behind the neck of pancreas. There it will join with splenic vein, which is also present behind the pancreas. So the splenic vein is coming from behind, and this splenic vein together they will join, and this portal vein will be formed. So therefore, this is the splenic vein, this is the superior mesenteric vein, and they are joining and forming the portal vein behind the neck of the pancreas. Then they will pass, this portal vein will pass behind the first part of duodenum, retroduodenal, and then it will pass supraduodenal, above the duodenum. So therefore, this course, this much portion of portal vein is infraduodenal, below the duodenum, this much portion is retroduodenal, behind the first part of duodenum, and this much portion is supraduodenal, above the first part of duodenum. Very simple. and the entire formation, always note down, will lie behind the neck of the pancreas. And therefore, here if I join, I will just show this is the splenic vein. Very light color I will use this because I have to show it is just behind the pancreas. And here it has joined. This has joined as portal vein. This is the superior mesenteric artery. And here, this is our portal vein, retroduodenal. And this is the portal vein, which is supraduodenal. So therefore, here we should always mark this as superior mesenteric vein. So here I have marked this as superior mesenteric vein. Then I will mark this as, here I will mark this as splenic vein. And here I will mark this structure as portal vein, where it is formed behind the neck of pancreas. Now as it travels above, supraduodenal, it will enter now here. One point you have to mark. As it travels supraduodenal, it will, after some time, after short course supraduodenal, it will enter the right free margin of lesser omentum. So therefore, here if I show the lesser omentum, this is the lesser omentum where the portal vein will enter. Right free margin of lesser omentum, where it will enter in front of epiploid foramen. This sentence is important because this sentence is asked in one mark question answer. The portal vein will be present in front of epiploid foramen when it passes through the right free margin of lesser omentum. So it is entering through the right free margin of lesser omentum, this portal vein, in front of epiploid foramen, and then once it reaches above, it will reach the porta hepatis. So here I will mark the porta hepatis. I am going to mark here the porta hepatis. And when I mark this porta hepatis, I will note it down, mark it down as porta hepatis of the liver. So after passing through the right free margin of lesser omentum, in front of epiploid foramen, the portal vein will enter the porta hepatis of liver. And as it enters the porta hepatis of the liver, it will divide into two branches. See here. So it is divided into two branches, the right and the left. The right branch and the left branch of portal vein. So here, please note down, this is the right branch of portal vein. The right branch, please note down, it is short and vertical, and this is the left branch of portal vein, it is longer and oblique than right branch, please note down. So the left is longer and oblique and the right is short and vertical. As the portal vein enters the porta hepatis, it divides into right and left branches, very simple. This is the course of portal vein. Now relations. Now in the relations, very easy, after understanding this course, the relations will start with the extrahepatic, intrahepatic. Now extrahepatic, now these relations where I am just showing you the area, these are the extrahepatic. Now in extrahepatic, the relations will be, the superior mesenteric vein will join with the splenic vein at the level of L2 behind the neck of pancreas to form the portal vein. Then the extrahepatic course of portal vein till it reaches porta hepatis, that is extrahepatic course of portal vein, that is around 8 cm in length. So the entire portal vein extrahepatic course is 8 cm in length. Relations will be in the infraduodenal part. As we have written, the relations will be infraduodenal, retroduodenal, supraduodenal. So therefore, infraduodenal, please note down, posterior there will be inferior vena cava. So therefore, now I am marking, inferior vena cava will lie posterior as posterior relation to all the three parts, infraduodenal, retroduodenal, supraduodenal. So I am drawing, simply I am drawing here, this part is inferior vena cava. Please note down, here what I am drawing is inferior vena cava. So here I am going to mark this as inferior vena cava. and this inferior vena cava will lie posterior to portal vein in all the three parts, infraduodenal, retroduodenal, supraduodenal. So the posterior relations are fixed. So infraduodenal, first part of portal vein, posteriorly inferior vena cava, then anteriorly, what is this structure? Neck of pancreas. So please note down, anteriorly neck of pancreas, where? Infraduodenal. Posteriorly inferior vena cava. Then right side. Now right side here, I will draw this. See here, pink, the green color I am using. The right side will be, now that also I am drawing in the form of dot dot structure. This right side, this structure is bile duct. So therefore, the right relation of portal vein in infraduodenal segment, right side is bile duct. So here I will mark this structure as bile duct. And here we finish the relations of infraduodenal part of portal vein. Infraduodenal part of portal vein, relations are very clear. Posteriorly inferior vena cava, anteriorly neck of pancreas, and on the right side bile duct. Now retroduodenal. Retroduodenal, the relations are posteriorly inferior vena cava and anteriorly first part of duodenum. But this first part of duodenum will be separated from portal vein by two structures. One on the right side, one on the left side. On the right side, what is continuous here? Bile duct. So I will continue this bile duct in this way. On the right side, bile duct. And on the left side, I will make an artery, and that artery will be known as the gastroduodenal artery. So here, this is the gastroduodenal artery. So these are the relations of retroduodenal part of the portal vein. And in retroduodenal part of portal vein, please mark once again, this is bile duct, and here, this is gastroduodenal artery. So, I will repeat once more. Retroduodenal, the relations are posteriorly inferior vena cava, anteriorly first part of duodenum, and right side bile duct, left side gastroduodenal artery. These two structures, the bile duct on right side and gastroduodenal artery on the left side, both the structures are related anteriorly to the right, anteriorly to the left, respectively. And these two structures will separate portal vein from the first part of duodenum. So in sequence from anterior to posterior, it will be, first is the duodenum, first part of duodenum, behind that on the right and left side will be the bile duct and gastroduodenal artery, and behind that will be portal vein. Then we come to supraduodenal segment. Now supraduodenal segment here, this is very important here, relations posteriorly inferior vena cava. So supraduodenal also the posterior relations are inferior vena cava. Then anteriorly and on the right side, please note now, here, anteriorly on the right side, there will be once again bile duct. Anteriorly and on the right side, bile duct. Anteriorly and left side, please note down this huge artery. And we mark this huge artery as the hepatic artery. So this is the common hepatic artery. So this common hepatic artery, it's one of the branches is gastroduodenal. Gastroduodenal artery is a branch of the hepatic artery. So therefore, bile duct on the right side and anteriorly, and hepatic artery on the left side and anteriorly. These are the relations of supraduodenal part of portal vein. And now, the portal vein, after entering the right margin of lesser omentum in front of epiplectic foramen, it will pass in portal hepatis of liver. Now here, one relation is very important which is asked in MCQ here where my finger is there. In the portal hepatis of liver, it is dividing into right and left branches, but here the relations will be from anterior to posterior. What are the relations? It will be at the portal hepatis, the first will be right and left hepatic ducts. Right and left hepatic ducts. Posteriorly, just behind the right and left hepatic ducts, there will be the right and left branches of hepatic artery, and behind that is the right and left divisions of portal vein. So please note down, this is asked in MCQs very often, the anterior to posterior relations at the porta hepatis will be, the first structure anterior will be the right and left hepatic ductules, that is lymphatic drainage, right and left hepatic ductules. Behind that will be the right and left branches of hepatic artery, and behind that is the right and left divisions of portal vein. So here we finish the entire course and relations of extrahepatic part. Now intrahepatic. Now from here it will enter the liver, the right and left divisions. So therefore, intrahepatic part, I will just guide you. Please come on this side. Flow chart, very simple flow chart. In the intrahepatic part, I will write here, intrahepatic part of portal vein. This is how you have to write. Now in this, divisions of portal vein. What are the divisions of portal vein? Right and left branches of portal vein. They will enter, this right and left branches of portal vein will enter portal canal. And what is portal canal? See, first of all, the right and left divisions, here I will just mention the right division and left division. Now the right and left divisions of portal vein, they will enter the physiological right and left lobes of liver. Always note down. The physiological divisions of liver, right and left lobe. So the right and left branches of portal vein will enter the physiological right and left lobes of liver. From there they will enter the portal canal. What will portal canal contain? It will contain the portal vein, that is the branches of portal vein, the branches of hepatic arteries, and also the bile ductules. From the portal canal, this blood from portal vein will be carried into hepatic sinusoids. Please note down, hepatic sinusoids. This flow chart is very important. This is how the blood will flow in the intrahepatic portion. So from the portal canal, the blood from the portal vein is carried into the hepatic sinusoids. They will pour their blood into hepatic sinusoids. From the hepatic sinusoids, the blood will then pass into central vein. Into the central vein. From the central vein, the blood will pass into the sublobular veins. So, sublobular veins. And from the sublobular veins, blood will pass into the hepatic veins. They will pass into the hepatic veins. This is very important. And these hepatic veins, the blood from hepatic veins will drain finally into inferior vena cava. So this is how the blood will circulate in intrahepatic portion. Please note down this flow chart. In this way the blood will circulate, and finally through hepatic veins they will drain into the entire blood from portal vein is drained into the inferior vena cava. Now tributaries. When we come, please come on this side here. We will just draw the tributaries. The tributaries of portal vein, number one, there will be superior mesenteric vein. There will be superior mesenteric vein and splenic vein. These are the formative tributaries. Superior mesenteric vein and splenic vein. So I will write down here, this will be the first tributary, superior mesenteric vein. This will be the second tributary, splenic vein. Please note down, two tributaries are over. Formative tributaries, superior mesenteric vein, splenic vein. Then another two tributaries at the stem of portal vein. What are those two tributaries? At the stem of portal vein, there will be two tributaries in the form of, just draw them, these two tributaries will be, we are just showing these tributaries, right and left gastric vein. So please note down here, these two, I will note down here, one is right gastric vein and another is left gastric vein. Tributary number 3 and tributary number 4. These are the tributaries belonging to the stem of portal vein. 4 tributaries, now 5 and 6. Cystic vein is a tributary which will open into the right branch of portal vein. So here in the right branch, please draw this tributary. And this tributary I will name as cystic vein. And this is tributary number 5. Cystic vein will always open in the right branch of portal vein. And tributary number 6, please show this as, now here, para-umbilical vein. So here I am going to write this as para umbilical vein, and I'm going to name this as trip number 6. Now here, this peri-umbilical vein, which will drain in the left branch of portal vein, always not down, it will connect below ligamentum teres and above ligamentum venosum. So in the lever, inferior margin has ligamentum teres and superiorly it has the ligamentum venosum. And please note down ligamentum teres, we have also discussed this during the embryology of the development of portal vein. The ligamentum teres is a remnant of left umbilical vein. One mark question answer MCQ. So once again I repeat, ligamentum teres is a remnant of left umbilical vein and ligamentum venosum is a remnant of ductus venosus. Ligamentum venosum is a remnant of ductus venosus. Please note down. So therefore this is the para-umbilical vein which will drain into the left branch of portal vein. So total 6 tributaries. First, once again I repeat, formative tributaries, there is superior mesenteric vein, second is the splenic vein, then 2 are over, then 3 and 4, they are the tributaries belonging to the stem of portal vein, and they are the right and the left gastric vein, and 5 and 6, they are the tributaries related to the right and left branch, right branch cystic vein and left branch para-umbilical vein. So therefore here we finish the entire anatomy of portal vein, but the applied anatomy of portal vein, which is left, which is also known as portocaval anastomosis or portosystemic anastomosis. Now this is a very important thing, so we are coming up in the next lecture, in the next segment. Thank you very much.